Hi, I'm Brian, aka 900BRZ. I'm back to talk about our test results with the prototype Killer B Baffle. In my last video, we established baseline oil pressure data for the FA24 engine on the track. If you haven't watched it yet, please watch that video first, as it provides important context for this video. The previous video garnered a lot of attention online, as well as getting coverage in Road and Track, The Drive, and others. Thanks for all your interest, despite the rather academic approach we're taking here. The goal is still to find a solution to these pressure drops and allow as many people as possible to enjoy these cars on the track. To that end, I'm pursuing mechanical baffles before more complex approaches like dry sumps or accumulators, which carry higher costs and increase the points of failure. Okay, back to this video. I had the Killer B prototype baffle and pre-filter installed in my car and went back to Thunderhill 5 Mile to see how it performed. Here you can see the lower pan is removed and you can see the pre-filter on the right and the baffle here. In short, we found no meaningful improvement between oil pressure drops before and after installing the baffle. This was a disappointing and surprising result, as I was previously convinced by the theory of oil surging forward into the timing cover. I want to stress that Killer B should be celebrated for developing this product in the open, even though we didn't get the results that we were hoping for. This is the kind of setback that occurs when you're willing to subject your products to real conditions and then follow the data. Parenthetically, this should also dispel the idea that my goal is to sell products from any particular vendor. For the rest of this video, I'd like to walk through the background for this product, then show the test laps with video and telemetry, and finally we can talk about where we're going to go from here. I wanted to share a little bit about the history of this product to give credit where it's due. Zero Omega, aka No Street Racing 86, was the first person I know of to report observing these pressure drops, all the way back in November of 2022. These pressure drops were corroborated by Track and Build. In March of 2023, Killer B Motorsport published the hypothesis behind this baffle design. Shortly thereafter, they made a call for testers, and that's how I got involved. They sent me the baffle free of charge, and I installed it with my own money. Okay, on to the test. We got control data at Thunderhill 5 Mile on May 22nd, with myself and local instructor Joe McGuigan driving. Then, with the baffle and pre-filter installed, we went back to Thunderhill to test it again. My car has no aero, low grip tires, and only minor alignment changes. I'm running the Jackson Racing oil cooler and the same oil as last time, Motul 8100 5W30. On the second track day, we experienced high ambient temperatures, over 100 degrees Fahrenheit, but I didn't want to introduce a new variable, so I kept the oil weight the same. This is the Thunderhill 5 Mile track layout. Unfortunately, we had a minor difference between the control and experiment days. Turn 5E, or 5 East, was substituted for a slightly slower corner called Cyclone on our experiment day. I skipped this turn in the data analysis as a result, but the rest of the track is exactly the same. So let's get into the laps. Like last time, I'll take a moment to acclimate you to all this data we're showing. We have the control lap on top and the experiment lap on the bottom. And I've pulled out some of the key data channels for each lap: lateral acceleration, RPM, and oil pressure. And I'll call out that this is just some very impressive driving by Joe. All I had to do is pause on the exit of turn 5 east to resync the two laps, and then the rest of it is straight out of the camera. Let's get into the laps now.
Thank you.
Okay, those are the laps. Just a couple things I want to call out. First, we don't see a meaningful improvement in the oil pressure measured on track. We can say that the time and cover theory is not supported by the data that we collected. Another observation is that the nominal oil pressure in the experiment day, that being the oil pressure at high RPM when there's no pressure drop, is significantly lower compared to the control day. Initially, I thought this was a result of higher ambient temperatures on the second day, but when I looked into it more, I found that there was an 8 psi difference in pressure even at the same oil temperature when compared to the previous day. We're not exactly sure what's causing this difference, but we believe it's possible it's due to the pre-filter. So I let Killer B know and they're looking into it. They told me they did flow testing and that the filter didn't make a significant difference in their tests, but they also said that they didn't test at the same temperatures we saw on track that day. For next steps, I'm planning to remove these products and explore other baffle designs. Now that the timing cover theory has been shelved, my area of focus has been shifted. The goal with baffles will now just be to keep whatever oil is present in the sump available to the pickup. The theory I'm working on now is that the oil is sloshing away from the pickup, which means it won't take long before the pump starts to pick up air. This is a more traditional approach with baffles, but hopefully it works. We'll also look at overfills and see if they make a difference. And I want to give a thank you to Joe McGregan, No Street Racing 86, Track and Build, and Killer B Motorsport, and I'll see y'all in the next one.